Do you see the video?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, okay. So we are in the left low without comment. First a question, there are two obvious suspicious signs in this nodule. Which are these suspicious signs?
Borders.
Yes, yes, so irregular borders. This has a clearly lobulated irregular borders, and great part of this nodule is deeply or very hypoechoic if we compare to the strep muscle. But now we focus on the extratidal extension, and in this case I present to the T4 parathyroid cancer, which has broken into the trachea.
Uh-huh.
So the problem that the tumor which breaks in the trachea cannot be clearly justified this type of extratidal spread. Again, in the ventral part, it is much easier to diagnose. In the medial part, due to the coarse calcification and due to the acoustic shadow, it is very difficult, or in most cases, it is impossible. Okay, we can it is suspicious only on the horizontal scan is important in this case. It is suspicious that it can be spread extratidal now into the trachea, but in this form, this absolutely not rare form of gross extratidal extension, it is very difficult or even impossible to rely on our ultrasound findings. So here is the extratidal spread, but it cannot be visualized on ultrasound. Do you agree with me?
Sure about that.
Yes.
Yes. So otherwise it is an unusual case of parathyroid cancer. I've met two parathyroid cancers in my practice, two primary, and it was no reason to suggest that this tumor was not of thyroid but of parathyroid origin. In such large lesions, we cannot rely on the location. But maybe Andrea may be on another view, because he is a very great expert of parathyroid lesions. Do you agree with Andrea that this is not a typical parathyroid?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, parathyroid cancer is a really rare entity. It's, well, maybe I've seen two or three cases. So maybe I've seen some more cases without understanding that was parathyroid also. But yes, in from your images, the chance of a parathyroid neoplasma, I think, was a likely chance, because one gets the impression that this mass is really out of the great part of the lobe. So somehow it has been generated outside the thyroid. So parathyroid tumor was a chance, but again, it's very rare. Yeah, of course, lobulated margins and the solid texture, and yes, the feeling is that of a malignant lesion. So,
yes, okay. Other questions, comments? If not, I follow with the next case.